Hey, if you love The Land of Quirk, you're going to embrace Inside Llewyn Davis. Directed by the Coen brothers, who know more than a little about odd worlds, it whisks you back to the 1960s when folk music was all the rage. Llewyn Davis is one of those aspiring folk singers working the streets of New York City, just hoping for a break. He had one a while ago, but his duet partner committed suicide, leaving him to go it alone. And so he drifts from club to club, couch to couch, just hoping someone will make it happen. Oscar Isaac is wonderful as the unlucky singer, able to wring emotion from just about any lyric. He has fun with a cat, too, and encounters such a wild bunch of friends, advisors, and family, you'll immediately want to learn more. Justin Timberlake, John Goodman, F. Murray Abraham, and Carey Mulligan are here, too, but it's that mesmerizing performance by Isaac that pulls you in and holds you. The music was supervised by T-Bone Burnett, and darn if it doesn't do for folk what O Brother Where Art Thou did for bluegrass. This isn't a typical film, but Coen Brothers production is, but it is one that will make you glad the Oscar-winning brothers constantly tilt at windmills. Also this week, Kellan Lutz, one of the background vampires in Twilight, takes a shot at playing Hercules. In The Legend of Hercules, we get the whole bloody story, complete with slavery, nubile women, and a rotten stepfather. Directed by Rennie Harlan, the guy who made a career of action, this Hercules has to choose between love or family, particularly when the one he loves is promised to his brother. Now you can imagine this has a lot of sword clashing and more than a few special effects than a Disney cartoon, but just know the producers have kept a tight lock on the picture and haven't let many see it. So in most cases, that doesn't bode well. Go with Llewyn Davis and you'll be in much better shape. There the gods deliver. Here, it's anyone's game. With your movies in a minute, I'm Bruce Miller.